Okay, in this part of the tutorial, we will have a look at the project settings you actually need to change in order for this to run on the Oculus Quest. And there's a great page from Oculus itself, the Unreal Quick Starter Guide. It's this one here. They also point out that if you really want to develop for the Oculus Quest with the latest SDKs and with the best performance, you should use the Oculus GitHub source from the Unreal Engine, because there's the latest SDK. And right now we are using the Epic Launcher, so it's a few versions behind, but it's very simple. You don't need any custom source, and you don't need Visual Studio to compile everything. You can just download it. That's the reason we're using it for this tutorial. But if you really want to get the most out of the Oculus Quest, you should use the Oculus GitHub source for it. And here are all the things you actually need to change in order for the project to run on the Quest. I found that there are some things missing performance-wise, but this is the basic you need to change in order for it to really start on your Oculus Quest. So let's go in there and change all of these. If you remember from the last tutorial, we created a completely new project, and there we changed the target hardware to not be maximum quality, but to be scalable 3D or 2D, and also this here to mobile and tablet. And this will change quite some things here. So let's apply those later. And we will also go in there and change some of these later, but it's a good starting point. So let's keep it this way and go back to maps and modes. We have checked everything we need in there. That is good. The next thing is under our input. There are our action mappings. That's also working, but here are some things we need to change. We may need to make sure that the default touch interface is cleared out. So let's clear it. And you need to make sure that there's none in there. The next thing, let's go down to the Android settings and click on configure our Android SDK now. For the SDK versions, you need to make sure that you are using 25 at least. So let's put 25 in there. The other things are good. We want to make sure that we use full screen on immersive. Enable full screen on immersive. We need to make sure that our Oculus signature is removed from our APK right now. This is only relevant if you want to upload it to the store, so we don't need to do this right now. We can also use the Oculus VR plugin. And if you don't see this here, you need to make sure that you open up your settings and plugins, and under VR, make sure that the Oculus VR plugin is enabled. If this is enabled and you go to your project settings, scroll all the way down, under plugins you should see the Oculus VR, and you may be familiar with this window from the last tutorial. There we can open up our performance window and select mobile, and then there are also some things you can change with just a click. So we need to enable multi-view. This is very important. It's basically instanced stereo, but for mobile. So let's enable this. And also we want to select the Oculus Quest from the devices we want to package for. Select this. And let's save everything up. And go in there and actually, this is fine, this has changed. So let's restart our editor right now in order for the changes to apply. So let's make sure everything has been applied. Let's open up the Oculus VR again and the performance window. Yeah, and this is a bug I often have with this plugin. So the changes didn't get applied, so I go in there and change it myself. let's search for package for Oculus mobile devices, and let's edit the Quest by ourselves in there. So make sure that there's the Oculus Quest. And there are some other things we need to change. This is one of the most important ones. Make sure that mobile HDR is off. If you don't turn this off, you will most likely get a black screen on the Oculus Quest with this project. And also in other projects, this is so expensive, you don't really, it's really not worth it in the end to turn this off, to turn this on for the Quest. So one thing you need to consider is post-processing is not working if this is turned off. And our highlighting effect was based on the post-process effect, but we went in there and created a new one, especially for the Oculus Quest. And I'm going to show you how we did it in the next tutorial. For now, let's turn this off and also let's check our render settings again. We want to use mobile MSAA 4 times. And let's scroll down. Occlusion culling is on. That's important. Texture streaming, we may turn this off later, depending on the size of the textures we are actually using. It can be more efficient to turn this off. The reflection capture resolution, we can turn this down because you won't be able to see it anyway in this big resolution. So let's make 32. Forward shading is not working on the Quest, so you don't need to turn this on. We want to use static lighting because we need to bake all our lightings, and we can use our normal maps for static lighting. This will increase the building process, but it will also improve the quality of the bake. So if you want really to have high quality, turn this on. I'm leaving it off for the tutorial now. If we don't use any post process, we can disable the custom dev stencil pass. This will also give us some performance benefits. Bloom is turned off, ambient occlusion is turned off. It's important that we have the ambient occlusion for static lighting because we want to bake the ambient occlusion into our light maps. So make sure this is turned on. Auto exposure is turned off. That's good. So this is all off. Motion blur and lens flares are also off. The anti-aliasing method, let's change it to MSAA. So we get a good representation on what the scene actually looks on the Oculus Quest. We don't need to support skin caches. This is turned on for the ray tracing, but we don't need this now. We restart later. We don't have any morph targets in there, so we can also turn this down. For the VR section, it's important that mobile multi-view is enabled and mobile multi-view direct, but it's also very important that you turn off instant stereo. And if you are familiar building VR for the PC, you always want to turn this on, but it is not working together with the mobile view. So make sure that this is turned off and both of them are turned on. Ray tracing is everything turned off and the rest should work. We don't actually need these atmospheric things here. We don't need to have a stationary skylight here. So let's turn this off. We don't need to have point light hole shadows. Turn this off. We don't want to have sky atmospheres. We don't want to have atmospheric fog, so we can turn this off. Maximal movable spotlights. We want to have actually two of them for the lights, so I write two of them in there. We want to support movable spotlights, but I'm I go back to this setting later in a later tutorial when we actually when we actually building the lights. So I leave it off for now, but we need to turn it on later. I just want to do it in the right tutorial. So restart later. We don't want to have distant field shadows. Don't need that. We don't need to have static and CMS shadowing. Don't need that. We don't want to have movable direction lights, so we can also turn this off. And this already should give us quite some performance gains. If we go back to the Oculus VR, there's this CPU level, the GPU level, and the FFR level. So this is basically how much performance you want to use on the CPU, on the GPU. 4 is the highest one. So best performance, but it also requires more energy. But for this scene, this is a really heavy scene. So I'm not quite sure. I don't think we have any CPU problems in there. So we may be able to leave this on the 2. But the GPU part is really heavy. So let's crank it up to 4. And also I want to use the fixed forfaded rendering effect here. The Oculus Quest has just a static one, so no eye tracking, fixed forfaded rendering. But in my opinion, and in my test, this gives you quite some performance boost, and it's not that obvious for not developers and not for people that are artists. So let's turn this on. I want to use the high preset in there. So it's a strong forfaded rendering. That means in the center of the screen, it's really sharp. And if you go to the edges of the screen, it gets more pixelated. But you are not really recognizing it that much. So let's turn this to high and restart our editor now.